It has been about a year since the world was introduced to the next generation of probably the most popular single-board computer in recent history. And since then, the extra power of having an ARM quad-core and up to 8 gigs of RAM for a low price has been the subject of tremendous experimentation by a large community of enthusiasts. While Raspberry Pi sees a lot of use in a large variety of fantastic projects, what I keep an eye on during this year is, what games can this thing play? And I mean beyond emulators. Now that finally RetroPie added official compatibility with the Pi 4, with the correct overclock settings, something like really good Dreamcast emulation is possible, which is outstanding. But my eyes wander to the world beyond retro console emulation, and oh man, has the community been doing its magic. And along with it, the microcosm of companies creating accessories for the Pi. When it originally launched, some of the immediate complaints about the new device had to do with poor thermals. Since this is a passively cooled device, a lot of adjustments had to be introduced by the Raspberry Pi company in order to improve idle thermals over time. But many companies have been busy developing some hilarious cooling solutions. For example, I bought this mini tower air cooler that makes the Pi look like a tiny, adorable PC motherboard, and I just loved it. But now, thanks to the active cooling, it is relatively simple to overclock the GPU to over 2 GHz and the GPU to 750 MHz, and the temperature is absolutely under control. In fact, the only reason not to go further is that often the Pi 4 will not boot with higher clocks, but that is a significant improvement, so let's find ways of using it. Since the Raspberry Pi is an ARM machine rather than an x86 computer like your laptop or gaming PC, running native PC games isn't exactly simple, since you need either the source code of the game to compile it for ARM or a very efficient emulator. So how about we start with something light like Doom 3? Doom 3 was the last Doom game where the legendary John Carmack worked on before moving to other things, and the last Doom game to enjoy an open source release, something that nearly a decade later is sadly unthinkable for a game of this caliber. So of course, clever developers have been trying to figure out how to get it to run in unexpected places. So here is DHEWM3, a port of Doom 3 for modern Windows and Linux using SDL. And as some people have figured out, if you install SDL2 from the Raspberry Pi repositories, as well as some other dev libraries, you can then clone this project and compile it on the Pi 4. All it needs are the game files, which you can get from a free demo or a Steam copy of the game, and when placed in the same folder, if everything compiled correctly and running the OpenGL driver, the game works. On a low resolution and low settings, results are honestly much better than I expected. Doom 3 was considered pretty graphically intensive back on its day, and this recompilation works really well, with often close to 60 FPS on cutscenes and at least close to 30 during movement or combat. Considering this is a community project, the results are super impressive, and I will not be surprised if further efforts could get more stable performance on this game. If I ever do a video on graphical tweaking for this game, this is a good target computer. Let's try something different, like running full Java Minecraft on a Raspberry Pi. Since Java Minecraft, as its name implies, it's a program running in Java, as long as there's a full Java environment on the Pi, it should theoretically run it. I followed the instructions in this forum post that I'm also linking in the description that basically involves installing Java and configuring Minecraft 1.12.1 to manually run it while using Optifine for better performance. While I'm sure more could be done to get something more stable, considering how CPU-heavy Java Minecraft can be, this is a testament of how much ultra-low-cost ARM chips have improved over such a short period of time. But it has yet to reach a place where someone can recommend it as a Minecraft machine, it is getting much closer. Which is why the next example might surprise you. This is one of my favorite indie games of all time, the gorgeous self-improvement journey that is Celeste. This is not an emulator, this is the full version of Celeste running natively on Raspberry Pi 4. Here's how that works. Celeste runs on Microsoft XNA, a set of tools and a runtime environment for games created by Microsoft and then abandoned in 2013, but that new games have continued to use all the way to today. Why? Because XNA lives on through projects like FNA, an open source re-implementation of XNA that works not only in Windows but in many other places, including Linux. FNA was created by video game porter Ethan Lee. And then there's projects like Monogame, which is an open source continuation of sorts for XNA. Why do I tell you all of this? Because I just find it very interesting how XNA basically allowed for indie game development before our current golden age of free-to-use environments like Unity, but also because Celeste shipped with an OpenGL implementation running on FNA. So if you can get the open source FNA working on the Pi, then you can run Celeste on it. LowSpec community member DJazz saw this article regarding running FNA on Odroid, another ARM single board computer. This inspired him to try and make it work on the most popular single board computer out there. This has taken some work and iteration, and I will definitely link to a more detailed resource if you have questions. Thanks to DJazz for sharing this and helping fact check this video. On an overclocked Raspberry Pi 4, their performance is honestly pretty amazing. On 720p, when there are 3D elements in the menus, frame rate can drop to a still amazing 30-something FPS. But as soon as you enter an actual level, frame rate climbs to pretty amazing numbers. Well, this is not on the level where you can play 1080p, considering how this is a pretty recent game that was not designed or optimized for an ARM computer like this, the result is still pretty amazing, and I think proves a lot of potential for modern gaming in Raspberry Pi. Which is why the next part is mind-blowing. No, this is not Windows 10. If only. Anytime I make a video about Raspberry Pi, I have to make the same clarification of this being an ARM chip rather than an x86 CPU, because one of the most common questions I get from curious community members is stuff like, can you try modern games from Steam? Can you emulate Windows games using something like Proton? Well, as far as I know, Proton is specifically designed for Windows to Linux transition on x86, meaning that it does not currently do the emulation that will be required for an ARM CPU. The first question is very interesting at the moment. Steam has lots of games natively ported to Linux on an x86 platform. Can we emulate those? In one of the few videos that I have made about emulation, I commented on how the natural overhead that comes from translating two very different platforms usually means that the platform doing the emulation has to be significantly more powerful than the platform being emulated. So imagine my surprise at Project Box86. Box86 is a project to emulate full x86 PC programs on ARM devices like a Raspberry Pi, and it works so much better than I expected. This is still heavily in development, so to test, I am using Twister X, a custom distro that is still Linux, but just modified so it looks more familiar to a Windows user, and more importantly for today, pre-configured with Steam and Box86 running games. This is still in very heavy development, so it's likely that by the time you see this video, compatibility in Box86 is going to be even better. But on the version pre-installed on Twister.s, more games work out of the box than I expected, mostly 2D games that already have Linux versions. Three examples of things that work really well at 720p are the marvelous indie mega hit Shovel Knight, or the surprisingly engaging Papers, Please. The third example is BA11 Hall A, a cyberpunk bartender simulator by the great Tsukuban Games, which just work out of the box with no problems. Now, I could not get this working on the version pre-installed on Twister.s, but Pylabs have been showing some of their more interesting advances recently, and the more bleeding-edge versions are working with more Unity games, both 2D and 3D, which is freaking huge! And they're working to try and get Wine supported, so the possibility of Windows indie games might be real in the future. This is the most excited I have been for the future of Raspberry Pi gaming in a long time. Also, fun fact, the person who wrote this article is the original creator of Box86. That's poetic. For the longest time, this fascinating mini computer has been known among gamers as a retro emulation box, but thanks to the efforts of people porting open source games, people porting open frameworks, or people straight up developing x86 emulators, it seems the increased power of the ultra cheap ARM platforms might point to a future of this being a cheap indie game and retro PC gaming box, and well, that is just very exciting. I'm definitely looking forward to the future of this platform.